Welcome back mga kababayan! Welcome to Selfmade Show! And guess what? Sino ang ating espesyal na bisita ngayon? Walang iba kundi si Mr. Joey Marcelo, President and CEO of Sante Philippines. Welcome to the show, Joey.
Thank you, Rebecca. It's an honor for me na makasama sa show mo.
Oh my God, it's so exciting. Pinanood kita last year anong naging Circle of Excellence ka ng awards. Anong pakiramdam mo noon?
Alam mo, sa akin, syempre, alam mo yung hard-earned, yung how many years of hard work, di ba? Parang pag na-recognize ka, it's parang fulfilling. Sabi ko, ang sarap ng pakiramdam and mas excited ka pa to strive to be a better person in the years to come. Mm-hmm.
So can you tell us, share with us about Sante Philippines? Mm.
Well, Sante International is a 100% Filipino-owned company. 16 years na kami, Rebecca. Imagine.
Oo,
16 years na eh. We started 2007, galing yan sa series of failing companies. And when we started Sante, we simply have a mission of helping people live better lives. I mean, once and for all, let's create something that will last a lifetime.
Mm-hmm,
so, nagsimula kami 16 years ago. And right now, I think we're an organization who's not only inspiring Filipinos, but even other nationalities.
Mm-hmm. So, how you started that and why?
We started Sante in 2007 with a primary purpose of providing wellness to humanity. Yan ang objective namin, to be a global provider of premier wellness products and services. Sabi ko nga, prior to Sante, for the first 7 years, 2001 to 2007, series of failures yan. Okay, 5 companies ang sinetup namin. By the way, we're into the direct selling business. So, it's more on inspiring people, creating opportunities for them. Pero yung first 5 years, the first 7 years namin, series of failures yan. Alright, from 15 na kapartner ko sa negosyo, 2007 Sante, tatlo lang kami. But we believe that something big is still about to happen. So, we just held on to that vision na malaki mangyayari. So 2007, when we discovered that there's a product pala, a raw material called barley grass. We don't know anything about barley. Sabi namin, it's worth a try. So pinag-aralan namin until we realized that this is something that we can really promote not only in the Philippines, pero pwede siyang maging global brand.
Di ba barley product, is that from Malaysia?
No. Well, barley kasi, kilalang-kilala ang barley in Asia using the barley grains,
yes.
Right? Pero what we're using is the grass. Kasi yung nutrients ng barley, nasa yung mga first few centimeters ng grass eh.
Anong grass yan?
Pag, barley grass. That's the name of the grass.
Ano ba yung barley grass na yan?
Para siyang damo talaga. It's
talaga?
Grass.
Okay.
Pero pag tumubo na yun, doon nagiging grains.
Oh.
Pero kami, before maging mature yung barley, hina-harvest na namin. And yung barley natin is from New Zealand.
I see.
People are asking, why New Zealand? Why not in the Philippines?
Yes.
Hindi kayang tumubo sa Philippines. Kailangan ng tamang temperature, tamang climate, and of course, yung klase ng soil. Why New Zealand? Because we believe that New Zealand is one of the cleanest countries in the world. And talking about organic products, they're one of the best.
Mm-hmm. And then, bakit naman you started parang direct selling?
Since day one kasi, since year 2000, when I first joined a direct selling company, I got so excited with the concept eh. Because the idea of direct selling is just building a community of people eh, di ba? Who loves enjoying life, people na ang ganda ng aspiration nila in the future. And in the process of us building this business, we're giving hope in the future for people eh. At nakita ko sa mga Pilipino, direct selling is a good opportunity to learn entrepreneurship.
Mm-hmm.
Alam kong malaking potential ang mga Pilipino. Yun nga lang talagang, I don't know if this is still the mentality, but for us Filipinos, it's still about studying hard and eventually finding a good job. Pero nakita ko, magandang direct selling na starting point to become a better entrepreneur.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the reason why I got so excited into looking into direct selling much deeper.
Mm-hmm. So far naman ang Sante International, how big are you guys now?
We're already a 16-year-old company. We have several thousands of distributors. By the way, we don't call them distributors, we call them business owners because we want them to have a feel na negosyante sila. We are already open in 10 countries. Late last year, during pandemic, we opened Sante USA and Sante Indonesia. So, may offices in 10 countries. And we're blessed because we're a Filipino company. But right now, we're the first ever Filipino company na nagkaroon ng sariling manufacturing facility in New Zealand. Tayo na ngayon ang may-ari ng manufacturing facility in New Zealand.
So, ibig sabihin, all the products from New Zealand are also you manufacture doon.
Yes.
So, tapos, isiship nila dito ang, tapos na?
Ang major raw material natin is the barley grass. So, mm-hmm. we process the barley there. So, pagdating dito, raw barley siya. So, pagdating sa Philippines, we have partner manufacturing facilities in the Philippines. So, iba-ibang application na yan. Of course, the main product is the pure barley one. Mm-hmm. And then, we have coffee with barley, chocolate drink with barley. But the main source, the main raw material is from New Zealand.
Oh, I see. So, parang manggagaling doon yung materials pagdating dito.
Ipoproduce na lang, ire-repack na lang sila, or i-manufacture into other products.
What kind of?
Yes.
So, now, paano, sino naman ang mga market nyo?
When we started the Philippines, direct selling kami. Even until now, okay, 90 to 95% of our market is the direct selling market. When we talk about direct selling, these are independent distributors. Mm-hmm. They're not employees of the companies. And they are the ones either sponsoring other distributors or selling the products in the market. Eh, ngayong panahon na to, Rebecca, talagang ina-inang online business eh. So, marami kaming mga online marketers. Mm-hmm. So, they do their marketing online. Kami naman, we support them with everything. Products, trainings, programs, plans, incentives. So, that's our main business right now. Although several years ago, we ventured into the mainstream na rin. We developed another brand for the retail market. So, nasa malalaking drugstores na rin tayo.
Ay, ganon. So, in terms, for example, if me, I want to join Sante. So, as a...
Aspiring
business owner. Oh. Business owner. So, how I make money?
There are several ways to join Sante. There are some people na... Ang gusto talaga nila is they just wanted to buy the products, right? Para makamura lang sila. So they join. They buy our package and when they buy our package, they receive products, they'll be given discounts na, di ba?
So normally, discounts average?
30 to 50% discount yan. Okay. It depends on the quantity of the products that they purchase. Pero some joined us naman because they wanted to also have a distribution business. Meaning, sumali sila because they like the product, they're using the products, pero gusto rin nilang ibenta sa ibang tao. So they are reselling our products, either online or face-to-face. But there are other people who would like to have a big business opportunity pa. Ano yung much bigger than selling products? By developing other distributors also. So nagde-develop din sila ng distribution network. Mm-hmm. Ang maganda, during these times, distribution network is not only in the Philippines.
International. Mm-hmm. And after 15 years, your top performing business owner, ano naman ang parang pinaka-average income?
Sa amin, Rebecca, as much as possible, we don't want to mention incomes of our distributors because it's confidential for them. Obviously, they're earning big. But for me, it's not only about the earnings, pero yung buhay na nabago. Mm-hmm. Like for example, these business owners, ordinary people before, but right now, they were able to acquire properties that they use for business. Imagine we have an ordinary distributor. Ito, napakasimpleng tao. Because of our business, nakabili siya ng resort during pandemic at yung resort na yun kumikita ngayon.
Very nice.
Right? So again, sa amin, it's not about the amount of money, pero it's about yung buhay na nabago. Mm-hmm. So, and we're proud to say that during pandemic, yung mga distributors namin, buhay sila.
Oh. So how you, anong plano nyo ngayon to really expand the business? To reach out especially, di ba, ang dami natin mga OFW, so how can you support them?
Most of our countries right now, 10 countries kami, most of those countries talagang puro OFW. And our battle cry right now is to empower OFWs. Talking about empowering them, it's not only giving them a business opportunity, but training them how to handle money, how to take care of their family. So ang goal namin is to train and develop them, alright? Right now, of course, good thing about OFWs is they're excited na mabago yung buhay nila. Mm-hmm. Kasi alam mo, Rebecca, I know you'll agree with me, na-experience mo to. Ang dami natin mga kababayan na tumatagal na 20, 30 years as OFW, pagbalik din sa Pilipinas, they're still the same. Right? And minsan mas lubog pa sa utang. So sa amin, ang inspiration na gusto namin ibigay sa kanila is, why not try to do something? It's not only Sante is the solution, daming solution dyan, pero why not give it a try to do something today so that 5 years from now, medyo mabago naman ang buhay nila. We're not encouraging them na umalis ka na dyan, umuwi ka na sa Pilipinas, but set up something so that someday, kahit umuwi ka sa Pilipinas, you have a business.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. How do you also reach out sa mga magulang or family ng mga OFWs dito? How you help them also?
What's happening kasi is, from the OFW in a country, for example, what happened is they support their families here in the Philippines. Mm-hmm. Of course, may negosyo sila rin, kumikita sila, but more than that, they're opening their minds of their, kasi ang nangyayari lagi ganito eh. Laging umaasa sa kanila eh.
Tama.
Right? Laging umaasa sa kanila, parang eh, hindi ko alam kung nalalaman ng family nila yung challenges ng mga OFW. So what we encourage them to do is endorse their family to us and we'll talk to them, not to offer them a business, but to present to them the reality. And inspiring them also that they can also help,
mm-hmm.
Alright? By doing several things while here in the Philippines.
Mm-hmm.
Not necessarily joining our company. Sometimes we're teaching them to set up their own businesses,
mm-hmm.
Diba? Via the help of their relatives.
Mm-hmm.
So tinuturuan namin sila kasi mm-hmm. kung hindi, nakakaawa, hindi lang sila
Tama,
yung OFW. Mm-hmm. Walang katapusan.
Tama, oo. Kaya nandun talaga yung pagbabago, no?
Yes.
Yeah. So what keep you going?
Sa akin, it's the passion of helping more and more people. Sabi ko nga eh, what's the difference of success and significance? Initially in life, parang gusto mo ikaw eh, kumita ka, umaman ka, pero gumraduate na tayo ron eh. Parang it's more on how can you be able to help other people reach a certain degree of success. Siguro naging passion ko na is a lot of people naniniwala eh. And sabi ko nga, even though may natitirang isa dyan naniniwala, lalaban pa rin ako. Pero hindi, ang dami eh.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the reason why it keeps me excited in doing the business. In fact, one of my dreams in the future is to hire someone who will run the company, a CEO. I'll just roam around the world because I wanted to be with our distributors. Not only Filipinos, but someday even other nationalities. I want to be an inspiration to them. Yun lang gusto kong mangyari.
Good luck. Diba, it's a challenge, right?
It's a challenge, pero sa akin lang, 1 out of 10 ang maniwala, happy na ako. Not everyone will believe you. Everyone will be excited, pero kinabukasan, babalik sila sa old usual ways.
Mm-hmm.
Isa lang out of 10 ang maniwala, happy na ako.
Okay na, yeah. Like you said that you gone through bankruptcy also, right? When you start different businesses in the world. So, how you able to overcome?
From day one kasi, I believe that direct selling is really the right venture. Simply because, alam ko yung mga international companies who's there for 50, 60, 70 years. I don't want to mention their names. But I know that there's a beauty in this profession. I call it profession, the direct selling profession. Nagkataon lang that we're doing something that is not yet right. So what we did is, during those failures, ano yung learnings? Ano yung pwede natin gawin? So series of repairs, series of vision fees, until nung dumating yung recent company, which is Sante, marami nang nakorrect. And true enough, na-correct na nga because 16 years and for me, para nagsisimula pa lang. Importante lang, di mawala yung passion. Di mawala yung belief. Okay, yung failure is not an option.
Correct. Yun. That's so amazing. So this year, anong goals ninyo? How big?
This year, exciting because for me, the pandemic is over. Ako sobrang challenging sa akin ngayon because I'm now roaming around the world. I just arrived from Cyprus and Dubai last Saturday. Tomorrow, I'll be going to Indonesia. This year, we're planning to open 2 new countries. One in Europe and another one in the Middle East. So keep on growing the business, keep on inspiring more and more people while taking care of the main business, which is Sante Philippines.
Mm-hmm.
The goal is to continuously grow.
Mm-hmm.
Bukas na ang market ngayon, we can now go out, we can start talking to people, and it's time to grow the business further.
Yeah. Now, one of the challenges in the Philippines, majority of us really want to get out Philippines, right? Kaya dami nating OFW. So what's your advice to them? Shall they really go out or they don't have to go out?
Alam mo, nakakatuwa. Kasi foreign companies wants to go to the Philippines because they know that there's a big business opportunity in the Philippines. Sabi ko nga, bakit hindi nakikita ng mga Pilipino na ang market really nandito? Napakaraming. Alam mo, honestly, may, of course, challenging ang pandemic, yung COVID, pero may beauty rin na nagawa yan eh. It shows us that there's an opportunity of building a business here and having an opportunity globally. Imagine there are Filipinos, working Filipinos in the Philippines, who's doing a business with us, na kumikita ng dollars coming from our international businesses.
Okay.
They don't have to go out of the Philippines. Stay here, build a business, and earn from all over the globe. Hindi na kailangan umalis sa mga Pilipino.
Okay.
We don't discourage them, kasi iba talagang gigil na, sige. Pero in the process, we are encouraging them to look at the beauty here in the Philippines.
Mm-hmm.
Look at the opportunity, because there's a lot. Nakita ng mga foreigners, bakit sila hindi nila makita?
Tama. Now, the one question na meron sila is, kung may kapital ka, wala akong pera, wala akong kapital, wala akong pinag-aralan, anong advice mo doon?
Alam mo, funny because, I don't know if you'll believe in me, when we started our business 23 years ago, wala kaming pera. May nahiraman kami ng maliit na amount na after 6 months, binayara namin at yun ay naging puhunan namin hanggang ngayon. So I always believe that it's not about the amount of money that you have, Pero it's about yung creating something from nothing. Alam mo, for Filipinos, like for Sante, for example, not to push the company. Pero like in Sante, you can build a business with us for only 1,500 pesos. Parang 1,500, they can start their own business. They can start their own reselling business. And we will teach them how to build the business online. Mm-hmm. Yung 1,500 na yan, baka after 1 week, may 5,000, may 10,000 na sila. Mm-hmm. Until they can generate a big amount of money for a bigger business. Eh. Mm-hmm. So, kaya magsimula na maliit. Ang challenge minsan, honestly, gusto ka agad big time.
Yes.
Pag sinabing business, ang nakikita ka agad, the millions, the luxury cars. No. They can start small. Mm-mm. I-build yan and someday have a big capital for a bigger business. Start small.
Oo, tama. So you also mentioned that you teach financial literacy. Kasi nakikita ko rin, I'm sure you know, yung mga OFW. Focus ko talaga OFW kasi they work so hard. Isa ako dun eh. Padala mo pera dito. I'm sure alam mo na kung sino yung mayaman. Mm-hmm. Sino?
Alam mo, nakakalungkot. No. Ano ba yung sabi ng isang kaibigan ko, OFW? Sabi niya, ano naman definition ng OFW? Overworked but financially worried.
Tawa. That's a good one.
Sabi ko talaga, kasi imagine mo, Joey, walang ipon, pero may iPhone. Tayong mga Pilipino, masayahin tayo eh. Di ba? Masayahin tayo kahit may problema, lagi nahangiti. Sa sobrang masayahin natin, bago pa dumating yung income natin.
Ubus na.
May medyasan na lang alis na eh. Diba, papunta na sa bayarin. Alam na kung anong gadget ang bibilin. So, napupunta sa kung saan-saan.
Yes.
Diba? So, I think financial literacy is so important. Mm-hmm. It's not how much money you make. Diba? Yeah. It's how much money you save and reinvest. Diba? So, yun yung kailangan matutunan. Challenging yan, Rebecca. Alam naman natin, hindi biro-biro. Kasi aspirational sa mga Pilipino yung, kumita ako eh, kailangan naman mag-enjoy ako. I believe there's time for enjoyment, pero balance lang dapat.
Yes.
And that's our objective, that's our goal, to educate and help and support them. Kung makinig, well and good. Kung ayaw, at least we've given it a try.
Mm-hmm. Yung nga lagi ko sinasabi na delay gratification, di ba? Kasi nga, yun nga sabi mo, gustong cell. Kung ako nga, cellphone ko, tinatawanan nila, pangit, right? But I'm happy as long as I can reach out. Tapos talaga, if you look, sino ang yaman sa Pilipinas? Mga malls. I'm sorry to say mga malls, ha? But talagang silang yun. Kasi lahat ng pera ng OFW right away, pumupunta doon. Tapos utang, right? Di ba 5-6 na pakauso niyan? It's so sad. So might as well yung sabi mong ganon, like your business, if they learn how to run a business like you, imagine ko ano mangyayari sa Pilipinas. Grabe, di ba?
You know, yung nature ng businesses namin, Rebecca, direct selling, or other people call it network marketing. And if you talk about network marketing in the Philippines, some people ayaw na niyan eh, di ba? Maraming negative connotation. Simply because, when you talk about network marketing, it's all about the money, di ba? Checks, cash, luxury cars. When we started Sante sa Pinano, time out na tayo sa ganun, di ba? Parang, for us, offering a business to give people an extra income opportunity, okay na yan. Mm. Di ba? It's not about the luxuries eh. Nagiging mentality tuloy yung mga tao, kaya kailangan kumita ng malaki. Kasi may bibili din akong malaki, di wala rin yung kinita mo. Kumita ka ng 1 million, bumili ka ng mga 1.2 million worth of, may utang ka pa. Mm. So it's about teaching them on how to value their hard-earned money. Mm-hmm. Right? Sino ba naman ayaw magka-iPhone? Lahat naman gusto. Pero kung yung iPhone, sakmal sa yung kamo, wag na. Pero kung someday, kurot lang yan, okay.
Okay. Diba? Yeah, it's so true kasi ako mismo. Diyan din ako kumita sa networking, right? Nagbibenta ako noon ng kaldero in Canada, right? And that's how I learned. Mm. Like even now in Philippines, I also joined Kayani because of the nutrition product nila, right? So I also so there's nothing wrong doing networking, really. Mm. Ako mismo naniniwala doon.
Mm. Ano kasi, what happened kasi, challenging yung profession which is network marketing because marami diyang tamang kumpanya. Mm-mm. Pero let's face it, there are other companies using the platform of networking para talaga, sorry for the term, pero parang mga scam.
Yes.
Let's not mention companies or details, pero nangyayari talaga ang daling gawing scam ng isang magandang profession. Mm-hmm. Pero kami naman, we keep on fighting by, like when we started Sante, let's focus on building the brand.
Yes.
More than promoting Sante as a networking company or a business opportunity, let's focus on building the Sante Barley brand.
Yes.
And if the product na-appreciate ng mga tao, ay yung negosyo madaling na. Mm-hmm. So yun yung objective namin. We're not trying to, parang nagsasabi, we're trying to correct direct selling. No, there's nothing to correct here. Mm-hmm. Just be an example. Just be a role model.
So true, pero kahit anong negosyo naman, kahit nga 'di ba Jesus Christ, marami ring nagalit sa kanya, dahil din naniniwala sa kanya. At may kapatid akong pare, marami ding laging maraming taong nagpupunta sa church, but you notice also na marami ring gumagawa ng mahirap pagsalita, right? Talaga din na ganun. So sabi ko sa kapatid kong pare, but why? Alam mo, sabi niya, the most important thing, as long as you're doing the right thing, God knows it, right? So ganun din sa tarawa sa negosyo natin.
Yeah.
Talaga maraming nagja-judge, right?
You won't be able to satisfy everyone.
Exactly.
As long as authentic yung purpose
yes.
mo. Diba? Alam mo, at the end of the day, alam naman natin yan.
Yes.
Nasa sa puso't isip natin.
Tama.
Yan. Alam natin if we're doing something that will benefit people
Mm-mm.
or will just benefit the pocket of the owners, di ba?
Yes.
So, alam natin ang tama tsaka ang mali. So, nasa atin yan. Because ako, Anise Rebecca, I believe we will be blessed based on the things that we're doing today.
Yes. Di ba?
Manloko ka ngayon, oh, kikita ka, pero hintayin natin
long
a few years from
yeah.
now, right?
Yeah.
So, we want to build something na pang long term, a legacy, di ba?
Uh-oh.
A legacy for the future generation.
It's so true. Like, for example, me, I'm still a human. So, mafe-feel mo pa yung disappointment, yung hurt. But, na-learn ko din na, ba't ako magagalit? Kasi I used to.
Mm.
Di ba? Kasi sensitive tayo. I used to get hurt for people na pag may sinabi, nasasaktan ka.
Yeah.
Now, I'm able to learn na, ba't ako magtatampo? They have the right to say whatever they feel, but it's up to me kung how I'm gonna carry that. Kasi kung kineri ko, nasaktan ako, ang nagsasuffer yung ako. Di ba ganun tayo?
Tama yun.
So, it's really very interesting being a human, honestly.
Tama. Parang ano rin yung Rebecca eh. Kung may hawak kong basura, binigay ko sa'yo, pag tinanggap mo, nasa'yo na yung basura.
Oh.
Hindi huwag mo tanggapin.
Di ba?
Huwag mo tanggapin. Wala
so
sa'yo, di ba?
It's so amazing, right? It's so
But
interesting.
But sometimes, kailangan ng ganitong kwentuhan
mm-hmm.
so that we can, you know, inspire people na ito
yes.
yung pwede niyong gawin.
Oo.
Kasi naapektuhan sila ng mga stories
yes.
eh, sa paligid, di ba?
Tama. Like sometimes also, sabi ko nga sa asawa ko, like, kung ako mismo, I gone through so many things, experience, challenges, but nasasaktan pa rin ako. Imagine sila kaya na walang experience, mm-hmm. na hindi sila nanggaling sa ganun. So, me, myself, I'm more worried or iniisip ko kung paano mo sila matulungan para yung pag-uunawa na yon.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi kung ako nga, nakong ko, na ganun pa rin ako, di lalo na kaya
Imagine
sila.
Imagine mo sila, di ba?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Kaya so many things that we can do, really.
Tama.
Kaya itong part ito ng story para pag napanood ka nila,
yeah.
they can learn a lot na, ay, normal lang pala yun.
Mm, ako, masaya na ako, Rebecca, of the millions of people na makakapanood sa atin, 10% lang sa kanila ang ma-inspire at mabago ang buhay. For me, fulfilled na, di ba?
So now, what's next to you? Ano mga next plans ninyo?
We will continue to grow the business globally. In fact, ang target namin in the next 10 years is to be open in a total of 30 countries, touching the lives of more people. And ako, I do believe that it's now time for Filipinos to be the head and not anymore the tail.
Yes.
We'll be the lender and not anymore the borrower.
Yes.
Kung before, we're just being sponsored by other companies. It's now time for a Filipino company to sponsor the world. So, sabi ko nga sa mga distributors namin, the world will be our playing field and we'll be inspiring a lot of people.
Mm-hmm.
So, what will we continuously do? Simple lang, we will continuously give hope to people. And that's mm-hmm. our objective in the years to come.
Mm-hmm. Do you reach out a lot to OFWs?
Yes, because we have offices in Hong Kong, Macau, Singapore,
nice.
Qatar, and UAE. And of course, nasa US na rin kami, marami rin mga Filipino ron. Yes, our major market, sila pa rin. Silang bumubuhay sa kumpanya at sila pa rin ang continuously ini-inspire namin to someday top other nationalities. Because we would like Filipinos to have a mentality na huwag kang matakot kausapin yung ibang lahi. Diba? Pantay-pantay lang tayo. Pag Filipino kasi minsan ang kausap nila, not to mention any nationality, ang tingin nila, mababa sila? No. Diba? Kahit na domestic helper ka ngayon, ngayon lang yan. And it doesn't define who you are.
Mm-hmm.
Even though you're a domestic helper, someday you can be an entrepreneur inspiring other nationalities.
Mm-hmm.
Ilang trabaho natin to
mm-hmm.
show them and prove to them that you're one of the best. Paniwalaan mo lang.
Mm-hmm.
Huwag kang maniwala na kung ano ka ngayon, yan ka na talaga, no? You can be a better person.
Yeah. Marami din tayong mga kababayan na they want to be successful, but they're at loss. Number one, sabi nila walang puhunan. Number two, walang edukasyon. Number three, walang contacts. And they're confused. So what's your advice to them?
First things first, may kasabihan nga, for you to change your life, you have to change the way you think. Siguro ang isang may papayo ko sa mga kababayan natin, OFWs, baguhin natin ang pananaw kung paano tayo mag-isip. Diba? Lagi kasing ang nakikita natin is imposible, wala akong pinag-aralan, mahirap ang pamilya ko, ito lang ako. No, it's not who you are today or before, it's who you wanted to be. di ba? Ngayon hanggang bukas. It's changing the way that they think and believing that something big and something great will happen to them and start something small. Di ba? I mean, yung what Sante is offering, marami nag-o-offer ng mga gandang negosyo.
Mm-hmm.
Maging open lang sila sa isang tamang negosyo and start small.
Mm-hmm.
Wala nagsisimula na big time kaagad.
Mm-hmm.
Pero maniwala sila that they can build something big that will go beyond a country, pang-global.
Mm-hmm.
Ibang magnegosyo noon kesa ngayon.
Mm-hmm.
20 years ago, para makapag-business ka outside the Philippines, you have to go there.
Mm-hmm.
Right now, internet lang, online, they can build a business globally.
Yeah, it's so true. Like, I mean, nung pagkapanahonan,
oh, dati,
you're still
diba?
Younger than me, of course. Di ba nun, you have to go to the library. Wala naman tayong library. Now, online, YouTube, you can learn so many things, di ba? Mm. Kaya, napakaswerte ng mga kabataan ngayon.
Yes, yes. O, lahat ng opportunity, ito lang maganda, no? Yung mga bata, lamang na yan. Pero even yung mga, ano, yung mga kasing idara natin, yung opportunity doon lang, kailangan lang maging open silang pag-aralan.
Mm-mm.
Sabi ko nga, ay, hindi ako makakagawa ng negosyo. Kasi hindi ako marunong mag-computer, pero nag-Facebook ka. Diba? Ang dami nag-Facebook na mga older. Eh, pareho lang naman yan eh. Just believe that you can still learn doing a business online.
Oo, tama.
Kayang-kaya. Posible. Walang imposible at hindi malaking kapital.
Oo. But how can they also find, kasi karamihan, especially the young generation, the vision, the passion.
Mm.
Yun ang parang laging ganun. I want to work if that's my calling.
Mm.
Or, diba, ayaw ko work kasi work is I won't enjoy, but if I do what I love, so paano nila malalaman ngayon that that's what they really love? Kasi they're confused too.
Sa akin, it's continuously inspiring them to explore possibilities. Kasi alam mo, minsan, may pros and cons yung digitalization, social media, ganyan. Kasi ang dami ng bata na confused ngayon eh. Kasi they always would like to compare themselves to other people.
Yes.
Diba? Gusto ko nito, ngayon. Etong gusto ko rin. Eh, lahat gusto. So, lito ka na. Sit down, focus, and try to do something that you're passionate about. Kung saan ka passionate, gawin mo, subukan mo. Okay? Don't be confused with so many information there. Kaya ako, honestly, all of us have 24 hours. Saan mo ginugugol yung 24 hours mo, yun yung difference. So I'd rather focus myself on things that I'm passionate about at alam ko na makakatulong sa akin in the years to come. Yung mga hindi makakatulong, iniiwasan ko na muna. Because if I'll be absorbing everything, nothing will happen. Pagising ko kinabukasan, I'm still the same person. Kasi ang pananaw ko sa buhay is, every day you have to be a better version of who you are. Diba? So I'll focus myself on my passion, and true enough, if I'll focus on that, something good might happen really in a few years' time. Kasi kung ano nangyari sa atin ngayon, dahil yan sa mga ginawa natin o hindi natin ginawa 5 years ago.
Tama.
So kung ano mangyari sa atin 5 years from now, dependent sa gagawin natin today. So do something that they're passionate about, they're excited, and 5 years from now, makikita nila, mag-harvest sila.
So how you do your time management?
I set my priorities. Okay, I set my priorities. Talking about my priorities, it's just to name my 5, ano? Our watchers, pwede namang kopyahin nila kung nakita lang para sa kanila yun, di ba? So my priorities, it's God, my family, business, community, and self. Kung meron akong kailangan gawin sa isang araw na wala sa 5 to, time out na muna. So before, nung bata tayo, di ba, every evening, ang gimmick tayo dyan. Nawala na sa akin ngayon yun. I'd rather be either with my family, with our distributors, or praying alone, myself, or building the community. So I focus on my priorities. My challenge to sa mga viewers natin, set your priorities in life. Right? Kasi kulang ang 24 hours natin eh. And if you have those priorities, you can manage your time well. Diba? Sa akin, social media is an avenue that can be of help to you or it can damage you eh. Ako kasi ang social media sa akin importante for business eh. Pero minsan social media nakakaubos ng oras. Pagharap mong ganyan, ubos na 1 or 2 hours. Learn how to maximize your time. Ako binibilangan ko laging oras ko eh. Not to be boring naman, diba? Pero 24 hours lang meron ako eh. Kung hindi ko pa aayusin yun, hindi ko pa ipaprioritize, sayang. Remember, ang oras na nawala, hindi na natin kayang ibalik.
So, nung oras ka gumigising, oras kayo natutulog?
Iba kasi ang activity ko eh. I'm active in sports also. I'm doing triathlon.
Yes.
I wake up early every day, 5 o'clock in the morning, because nag-start ang, yung mga kids ko kasi active in sports din. Like, by 5:30 a.m., I'm with my youngest son, 12-year-old. May train na siya. Running, train din ako. Every day, I either bike, swim, or run. That's 5:30 in the morning hanggang mga 8-9 yan. By 9 o'clock, start na ako. Either nasa office na ako niyan or nasa meetings na. Usually, every afternoon, I'm with the distributors already. Mm-hmm. And I keep it a point na every day, kasama ko yung wife ko, we have dinner with the family. Ngayon may school, so bihira akong makasama yung mga kids ko for lunch and dinner. Pero I keep it a point na kumpleto tulog ko. Dapat 7 to 8 hours ang tulog ko. Mm-hmm. Maximize yung time at yung limang priorities ko na daanan ko lahat yan. Mm-hmm. Araw-araw. Importante sa akin ang health, and that's the reason why I'm trying to be active in sports pa rin. I compete a lot. I just, mm-hmm. kagagaling ko lang sa London, I run the London Marathon.
Crazy.
Kailangan ko lang. Kailangan isama ko yun. Yeah, okay. Not only because we're a health and wellness company, pero I would like to, sabi ko nga, I would like to die young as old as possible.
Die young.
I would like to die young as old as possible. Meaning, gusto ko at the age of 80, 90 years old, I'm still competing, I'm still running, yes. I'm still biking. Yes. Mm-hmm. Pero hindi ko magagawa yon if I won't prepare today.
Yes, good for you. Mm-hmm. Okay, so last question. So what's your advice din sa ating mga kabayan para at least together we can make Philippines a first world country?
Yeah, especially to our OFWs, kababayan natin. You're there because there's a purpose. There's a purpose. Not only to work, you're there because there's a better opportunity for you. Just believe that Filipinos are destined for greatness. Nandito tayo, hindi lang para maging trabahador, pero nandyan kayo because you're destined to conquer the world. You have to be sure na habang nandyan ka sa country, kung nasaan ka man, makita mong opportunity dyan. Na balang araw pag uwi mo sa Pilipinas, yung kinikita mo at negosyo mo, hindi rin umuwi ng Pilipinas. At ang pangarap ko para sa inyo, balang araw, na gusto kong pangarapin nyo rin, balang araw, you're with your family, you're with your loved ones, at yung hard-earned money mo, ginagastos mo, kasama yung mga mahal mo sa buhay.
Amen. Yeah, maraming salamat, Joey.
Thank you so much, Rebecca. Thank you for the opportunity.
Yeah, and good luck, ha.
Thank you.
Nakakatuwa ang senior sa atin ni Mr. Joey Marcelo kasi nag-umpisa din siya na very simple na tao. But now he's able to build a big organization, right? Yung Sante International. Ang dami niyang tinutulungan na mga Filipino to run businesses in direct selling. Nasabi nga niya kahit ang daming nagbaba sa kanya, pero nakafocus siya kung saan papunta kasi kung saan siya papunta ang pagtulong ng mga kababayan natin, lalo na ang mga OFWs. Teaching them how to run a business, hindi lang sila na nasa ibang bansa, kundi ang kanilang mga family din dito para at least hindi na aalis ang kanilang mga pamilya papunta sa ibang bansa. And that's why he's so passionate of helping OFWs to run their business. Kaya ang tawag nga sa kanila is to be a CEO of your own company. Kaya sana sa senior niya, meron kayong mapupulot na pagbabago, na don't give up, na talagang i-keep niyo yung hope ninyo dahil kung meron yan, talagang pupunta kayo sa dapang paraan. And I hope that we can continue by making Philippine first world kasi kung matulungan nyo yung mga sarili, yun ang pagbabago ng ating bayan. Maraming salamat at hanggang sa muli.